Hello, Ankush.
I think he went off. I don't see him. Oh no, he's here. I can unmute if he wants to speak. Ankush, do you want to introduce? Do you want to start the webinar?
Hello everyone, Johar, Namaskar. Let's start with my introduction once again. I'm Ashish Biruli. I'm an activist, a writer in Youth Ki Awaaz, and a content creator for Adivasi Lives Matter. I'm associated with an anti-nuclear movement, and the organization is called Jharkhandi Organization Against Radiation, and with a small organization called Desauli Foundation from Jamshedpur. So the topic on which we are going to talk is Adivasi identity, and I think this this Adivasi is a very diverse topic. So before knowing about Adivasi, I think first, you have to learn who Adivasis are and what is their identity. And this series will be in four episode. Srejani will organize another three episode for this. So we'll begin with the word identity. So what is identity and what makes an identity? So according to me is we have history, culture, language, surname, and the community from which we belong, the name of the community. All these things makes an identity of a person. तो ये सारा चीज जो है ये आइडेंटिटी तय करता है हमारा आदिवासियों का जो आइडेंटिटी है. हम यहाँ पर 6,000 साल से हैं. हमारा यहाँ पर अपनी परंपरा है, अपनी संस्कृति है, अपना सरनेम है. फिर हमारा जो मैं जो कम्युनिटी से आता हूँ वो एक हो समाज कहा जाता है. तो ये सारा जो है ये आइडेंटिटी बनाता है. द नेक्स्ट वर्ड इज आदिवासी. सो माई क्वेश्चन इज हैव यू व्हाट व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट थिंग यू इमेजिन और व्हाट मतलब आपके मन में सबसे पहला क्या इमेज आता है आदिवासी वर्ड सुनने से. Can anyone want to answer? Gangotri.
Yeah, hello. I'm from Pune, and Adivasi, I have heard in my mother language, which is Bengali. And Adivasi, if we break the word, Adi is जो कि पहले से है, पहले वाला. आदिवासी, वासी मतलब जो लोग रहते हैं. तो आदिवासी इटसेल्फ हम ऐसे ही बचपन से पढ़े हैं कि जो लोग पहले से ही है, दैट इज आदिवासी.
एग्जैक्टली. तो हम आदिवासी जो वर्ड है क्या अंडरस्टैंडिंग आता है उसका, एक्चुअल मीनिंग क्या है? आदि, जो आदि काल से जो लोग रह रहे हैं इस भारत पे, उसे आदिवासी कहा जाता है. वो एक समझ में आता है आदिवासी. लेकिन ये आदिवासी जो वर्ड है इसका एक बहुत सारा दैट्स अ बिग मिसकंसेप्शन अबाउट द वर्ड आदिवासी. When you ask someone what does आदिवासी mean, the first thing they will say that जंगली है, लोग जंगल में रहते हैं, अनपढ़ है, गंवार है, जाहिल है. They tag आदिवासी with every possible negative words. ये एक सच बात है. यहाँ पर जितना भी होता है हमारे यहाँ पर, तो मैं बचपन से यही एक्सपीरियंस किया हूँ. एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज व्हेन पीपल फ्रॉम आवर प्लेस, व्हेन दे आर माइग्रेटेड, व्हेन यू आस्क देम दिस सेम क्वेश्चन, दे से दैट वी फील इनसिक्योर अबाउट रिवीलिंग अवर आइडेंटिटी. लाइक बिकॉज यू स्टे इन विशाखापट्टनम एंड दिशा यू स्टे इन बैंगलोर. इफ एनी आदिवासी from Jharkhand is migrated to your place, they feel very insecure among the non-tribal majority. The thing is, the word, the true meaning of the word is hidden. The word is propagated in a very negative manner. And why this has happened, I will tell you. Adivasi are the first settlers of India. And this is the fact. And I think, and this fact cannot be denied. But some other group also came, like Arya, like Mughal and British. They also came. But we know that Mughal came after Arya. And they are, we consider, they are easily considered as outsiders. And even the British people. But Arya people, they also claim that they are also indigenous. Vikas, sahi bol raha hu na?
Haan, bilkul, bilkul.
Bilkul, Arya log bhi wahi kehte hain. कि मैं भी मानते हैं. तो इसमें क्या है, कंफ्यूजन है. मतलब कि बोलते हैं ना कि अब कौन है, हु इज द एक्चुअल इंडिजिनियस पर्सन. तो इसमें एक पॉइंट आता है, द वर्ड आदिवासी अराइव्ड व्हेन आर्या केम टू दिस इंडिया, दे सो दैट देयर आर ऑलरेडी सम पीपल लिविंग, ऑलरेडी लिविंग. हम लोग इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन के बारे जानते हैं ना, तो वो जब आई व्हेन दे केम दे सॉ दैट देयर आर ऑलरेडी पीपल हियर, दे आर लिविंग हियर. तो वो लोगों को क्या लगा कि यहाँ तो पहले से लोग रह रहे हैं, और इतने साल के बाद ये तो उनका जो इंटेंशन था यहाँ पर, वो बिजनेस पर्पज से आए या यहाँ पर जमीन हड़पने के लिए आए, उनका वो अपना इंटेंशन था. लेकिन जब बहुत साल, दे स्टेड फॉर वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम इन दिस प्लेस, इन दिस लैंड, सो दे थॉट दैट वी विल क्लेम आवरसेल्व्स एज इंडिजिनियस. और ये जो आदिवासी है उनको हम लोग दबा देंगे. तो दैट वॉज देयर इंटेंशन. एंड हुआ ये कि दिस वर्ड, ये वर्ड को इतना नेगेटिव वे पे बताया गया लोगों को कि द पीपल फ्रॉम माय ओन कम्युनिटी स्टार्टेड फीलिंग अशेम्ड. दे स्टार्टेड कॉलिंग आदिवासीज विथ ऑल द नेगेटिव वर्ड्स. एंड दिस ऑल हैपेंड विथ पर्पसली. And this was the ideology of the Aryans. ये बात है. तो हम लोग देखते हैं कि ये तो है, इनको main motive था to demoralize the Adivasis, to discourage the Adivasis, and it really happened, and they succeeded in doing this. I would like to name one very legendary and prominent leader of Jharkhand. His name is Jaipal Singh Munda. The youth of India does not know him, and he is a very important person. I think every person should know about him. We call Jaipal Singh Munda as Marang Gomke. And he was the first Indian to bring gold medal in 1928 Olympics in Amsterdam for hockey. And but his name is not taken. I tried to search in Google if anything is written about him in big magazines, online platforms. First thing I typed in Jaipal Singh Munda, BBC World. There is nothing. जो लोकल न्यूज़पेपर है, लोकल यहाँ जो पर्सनल ब्लॉग्स है लोगों का, उसमें उसका पाया जाता है, इमेजेस है, तो लोगों को मालूम ही नहीं है उनके बारे. एंड ही वॉज द फर्स्ट पर्सन टू क्लेम फॉर अ सेपरेट स्टेट फॉर the Adivasi people. And he also joined politics in 1940s, before the Independence Day, before the independence. And he had a lot of contribution in making Constitution of India, especially for the indigenous people. मतलब आदिवासियों के लिए बहुत सारा उन्होंने बात किया, क्योंकि कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन पे सबसे हमें डॉक्टर अंबेडकर के बारे मालूम है. एंड वी सबको मालूम है कि ही उन्होंने ही सब काम किया है कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन पे. लेकिन हम लोग बोलते हैं कि आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड हिंदी, श्री रंजनी यू एंड तो उन्होंने कहा कि आदिवासी, उन्होंने दलितों का मुद्दा उठाया था और दलितों के बारे में ही बहुत कुछ कहा. बट मैं क्रेडिट देवपाल सिंह मुंडा को ही देना चाहूंगा, क्योंकि उन्होंने ही कहा था कि हमें कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन पे आदिवासियों के लिए अलग से राइट्स बनाने हैं हमें. इट वॉज नॉट अंबेडकर, इट वॉज जयपाल सिंह मुंडा हु डिड दैट. तो अंबेडकर एक वर्ड यूज किए थे आदिवासियों के लिए, वो वर्ड है असभ्य लोग, जिसको हम अनसिविलाइज्ड बोलते हैं. The question is, he belonged from a Dalit community. He belonged from the Dalit community, and he himself has seen untouchability and lots of issues among his community. And even then, he used that word uncivilized for Adivasis. And which does not make us happy knowing that. And this is the fact. And I did a research. There is a round table. There's a blog. There's a link in which I read about him.
Round table India.
I think you have read that. उसमें दिया हुआ है ये बात. और ये बात दिया हुआ है. तो इसमें क्या लगता है कि सही ऐसे बोलना नहीं चाहिए था. हमने बहुत सारा चीज किए हैं. तो इसमें ये मैं दिखाना चाह रहा हूं कि सब कोई आदिवासियों के लिए नेगेटिव वर्ड ही यूज किया जाता है. और जयपाल सिंह मुंडा ने एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट बात कहा कि आदिवासियों को आदिवासी वर्ड से ही पुकारो, उनके लिए दूसरा शब्द मत जोड़ो, दूसरा शब्द नहीं चाहिए हमें. आदिवासी का इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन होता है एबोरिजिनल. एबोरिजिनल का हिंदी ट्रांसलेशन आदिवासी है. तो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में वही नाम रखा जाना चाहिए, लेकिन वो नाम नहीं रखा गया आदिवासियों के लिए. और महात्मा गांधी, जयपाल सिंह मुंडा ने ही कंटिन्यूसली टोल्ड एवरीवन, इवन इन दी कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली इन फ्रंट ऑफ एवरीबडी, ही टोल्ड दैट we Adivasi, we like this name and we should be called with this Adivasi word and no other word is accepted. But even then, Mahatma Gandhi used a word Girijan. Girijan is a word, Giri means jungle and Jan means log, jungle ke log. Mahatma Gandhi also used that word. He didn't use the word Adivasi. And you know, Narendra Modi also, he never call us Adivasi, but he say he used the word, but he also use a word one bandhu, mere jungle ke dost. तो मेरे जंगल के दोस्त है ये लोग. तो ये एक वर्ड यूज करते हैं वो. और एक जंग वन बंधु योजना भी है. तो मेन चीज है कि इतने सारे वर्ड है, आप एक एक पर्टिकुलर वर्ड आप आदिवासियों के लिए यूज नहीं किए हैं, सब अलग अलग शब्दों से, अलग अलग नामों से आप पुकारते हैं आदिवासियों को। तो ये एक चीज जो है आदिवासियों को इतना डिमोरलाइज कर दिया है कि लोग अपने आप को आदिवासी बोलना भी बंद कर रहे हैं, एंड दे हैव स्टार्टेड हाइडिंग द सरनेम आल्सो द आदिवासी। तो कहीं ना कहीं जो आदिवासियों की जो आइडेंटिटी है वो छुपते जा रही है और लोग उसको रिवील करने से डरते हैं। दे डोंट फील प्राउड ऑफ रिवीलिंग देयर आइडेंटिटी, एंड पीपल हु आर कंसर्न्ड, हु आर एजुकेटेड एंड हु नो अबाउट दैट राइट्स, दे नो दैट लाइक मी, मुझे मालूम है इसलिए मैं कह रहा हूँ, मैं गर्व से कहता हूँ मैं आदिवासी। बट वॉट अबाउट पीपल who are not illiterate, and the majority in Adivasi are illiterate people. जो गांव पे रहते हैं उनका क्या है, वो कैसे फील करते हैं, क्या उन्हें गर्व है आदिवासी होने पर, ये तो सवाल उठता है। तो ये एक चीज है, और इसमें बहुत सारे लोग, जैसे मैंने कहा अंबेडकर जी, महात्मा गांधी जी, नरेंद्र मोदी जी, इतने प्रोमिनेंट लोग ऐसे वर्ड यूज कर रहे हैं आदिवासियों के लिए, तो आदिवासी लोग तो ऑब्वियसली वो तो डिमोरलाइज होंगे ही। और जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन है उसमें आदिवासियों के लिए एबोरिजिनल वर्ड यूज नहीं हुआ है, उनके लिए वर्ड यूज हुआ है शेड्यूल ट्राइब। इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया फॉर आदिवासी देर इज नो वर्ड एबोरिजिनल नॉर आदिवासी, they are identified as scheduled tribe. तो scheduled tribe का दूसरा एक meaning होता है, जो tribe है there's a meaning है उसका। मैंने एक Gladson Dungdung का एक YouTube में video देखा है, आदिवासी हुंकार, उन्होंने बहुत अच्छा से कहा है उसमें, और उसमें उन्होंने कहा है कि आदिवासी जो tribe word है उसका मीनिंग ही है कि दूसरे दर्जे के लोग। और हमें तो बहुत दुख इस बात का लगता है कि ये भारत के जो फर्स्ट सेटलर है, ये तो यही हो गया है ना कि somebody, suppose I'm giving an example, suppose you go to someone's house and you claim that you claim that house to be your own and not the original owner, and what you do is you make that owner live as a renter in his own house, and you will ask him to pay rent, and after that you will ask him his identity. मतलब आपको अपने ही घर पे आपका पहचान पूछा जाता है, तो ये एक चीज है। तो ये चीज है, तो ये तो बुरा तो लगता ही है हर किसी को जब हमें अपना इतिहास के बारे में पता चलता है, तो ये एक चीज है, तो ये बुरा लगता है। और एक चीज है, हम लोग आगे डिस्कशन में ये बात करेंगे कि जो एक कास्ट सिस्टम जो बना हुआ है आदिवासियों के लिए, कास्ट सिस्टम आदिवासियों के लिए बनाया गया है, सिर्फ आदिवासियों के लिए नहीं, जो पूरे जो भारत के जो वासी है उनके लिए बनाया गया है। कास्ट सिस्टम पे आते हैं, रैंक वाइज आते हैं ना विकास, इसमें सबको आते हैं, ब्राह्मण आते हैं, राजपूत आते हैं, उसके बाद जो जो आते हैं शूद्र आते हैं, दलित आते हैं, तो इस तरह से लोग आते हैं। तो ये इसमें क्या होता है, उसके बाद उसमें आदिवासी को भी डाल दिया गया है, और ये कारण ही है कि आज के टाइम में हर कोई अपना कास्ट सर्टिफिकेट लेके बनाने के पीछे रहता है। नाउ एवरीबॉडी इन इंडिया मेक अ कास्ट सर्टिफिकेट, उन्हें कास्ट सर्टिफिकेट बनाना कंपलसरी है। तो सवाल ये है कि जब आदिवासी कास्ट सिस्टम पे आते नहीं है तो वो कास्ट सर्टिफिकेट क्यों बनाए। द क्वेश्चन इज, if the Adivasis say that they don't come under caste system, why is it necessary to make caste certificate? And I have a great example for this. In caste system, in Hindu, उसमें क्या होता है कि ब्राह्मण फैमिली में ही पंडित बनते हैं और वो ही पूरा पूजा पाठ करते हैं. लेकिन आदिवासी में ऐसे होता है कि हर आदिवासी जो है उनका अपना अपना कम्युनिटी पे अपना प्रेस्ट होता है. अदे मैं भी एक होक समुदाय से बिलोंग करता हूँ और मैं अपना समुदाय में हम लोग भी हम लोग पूजा करते हैं. तो हम लोग बोलते हैं कि हम लोग भी एक आदिवासी पंडित फैमिली से है लेकिन हम लोग पूजा करते हैं. पूरा गांव का जो पूजा होता है हम लोग पूजा करते हैं. और आदिवासी कम्युनिटी पे ऐसे भी होता है कि इंडिविजुअल फैमिली अपना पूजा करते हैं और एक दो जो बड़ा फेस्टिवल होता है उसमें ही हम लोग पूजा करते हैं. हम लोग डिपेंडेंट नहीं रहते हैं. इसमें मैंने ये है कि बच्चा पैदा होने से लेकर के मरने तक जितना भी होता है आप बाकी कम्युनिटी पे होता है कि नॉन ट्राइबल कम्युनिटी पे क्या होता है कि उसमें ब्राह्मण ही पूजा करते हैं. उनके बिना नामकरण तक उनका ही होता है, उनके बिना नहीं हो पाता है. लेकिन आदिवासी में वैसा नहीं होता है. आदिवासी में हम लोग हर चीज हम लोग खुद ही करते हैं. तो ये एक पॉइंट है जो हम लोग को अलग करता है बाकियों से. और बहुत सारा ऐसे एग्जांपल आप लोगों को देना चाहूंगा, जैसे कि आरडी बर्मन को आप लोग जानते हैं. आरडी बर्मन वो एक त्रिपुरा के आदिवासी है. उनका आप गूगल करके भी देख लेंगे तो उनके जो ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स हैं वो भी त्रिपुरा के हैं. और त्रिपुरा में आरडी बर्मन का पूरा नाम है राहुल देव बर्मन. और वहां पर जो इंडिजिनियस कम्युनिटी है त्रिपुरा में, एवरीबॉडी यूज दैट, द मेजोरिटी यूज दैट सरनेम, इंडिजिनियस कम्युनिटी देव बर्मा. लेकिन सवाल ये आता है कि इन इंडिया नोबडी न्यू दैट ही वाज एन इंडिजिनियस पर्सन. द फैक्ट वही हम लोग कोरिलेट करते हैं. द फैक्ट इज पीपल आर अशेम्ड, people who become successful from Adivasi community, who migrate to another place, and when their lifestyle changes, they feel ashamed of calling themselves as Adivasi. So, ये एक reason हो सकता है. और ये हम लोग आरडी बर्मन में देखते हैं. और हम लोग तो जानते ही हैं कि वो इतना बड़ा legendary music composer है. So, people like them, they hide their true identity, then what about the common people? And everybody know about Mary Kom. Mary Kom is Adivasi. Everybody know that. I also would like to name the filmmaker who won the Oscar, Taika Waititi, the New Zealand filmmaker. He also belong from an indigenous community, and he gave a very wonderful Oscar acceptance speech, and he is very proud of his community. He is very proud, and in 2015 I had an opportunity to go to Canada, and I met the indigenous from indigenous people from Canada. They are called as First Nation people. First Nation. So when I met them, everybody is so educated. Everybody was so proud of themselves. And they have, मतलब वो लोग अपना culture को इतने पकड़ के रखे हैं. And what I thought is, हमें भी उनके जैसे बनना है, हमें भी वैसे प्राउड फील होना है. और ये मुमकिन कैसे होगा? प्रॉपर अवेयरनेस. और ये जो प्रोपेगेंडा चलाया गया है भारत पे बाकी नॉन ट्राइबल्स के थ्रू, ये हमें समझना है. और दूसरा सबसे बड़ा बात है कि जब लोग द पीपल हु नो दैट दे आर प्रिविलेज्ड एंड दे आर मच अवेयर देन अदर कम्युनिटीज देन आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट देम दैट इफ यू आर सो प्रिविलेज्ड देन डोंट थिंक दैट यू आर सुपीरियर देन मैनकाइंड. Be proud of yourself, but don't think you are superior. And this applies with the Adivasi community also. I am proud of Adivasi. I know my history, but it does not make me think that I am superior than others. It does not make me think. So, ये तो वही हो जाएगा ना कि जो privileged है, जिनके पास में power है, वो हमारे साथ जो कर रहे हैं. और अगर हम आदिवासी के पास पावर आ जाएगा तो क्या हम भी वैसे ही करेंगे? तो ये एक बहुत बड़ा है. तो ये वैसे नहीं होना चाहिए. वी हैव टू रेस्पेक्ट इच अदर एंड व्हाट इफ आई एम सेइंग दिस इज नॉट फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ प्लेजर. इट इज इन द पर्पस ऑफ शेयरिंग व्हाट आई नो. नॉलेज शेयरिंग हो रहा है. What I know, I will share it with you, and what you know, please share it with me. तो जो ज्ञान का जो आदान प्रदान है ये हमेशा होना चाहिए. और जो ये respect हम लोग एक दूसरे को एक लोगों को करना चाहिए, that should also be continued. हम आपको respect करें और आप हमें respect करें. इसी को तो humanity कहते हैं ना, इसी को mankind कहते हैं. नहीं तो फिर हम लोग क्या हो जाएंगे? आप ये हो, आप वो हो, हम ये है. अरे अगर हम लोग बोलते हैं ना कि अगर हम लोग, हमारे पास एक वर्ड होना चाहिए, यू आर यू ह्यूमंस. अगर हम अपने आप को अलग करेंगे तो फिर दिक्कत हो जाएगा. हम लोग तो अपने आप को, तो हर इंसान को तो बोला जाता है ना कि हम लोग डीएनए तक से अलग कर सकते हैं. ईच इंडिविजुअल कैन बी.
आशीष, यू हैव सम क्वेश्चंस. सॉरी फॉर इंटरप्टिंग यू. Shivani is asking, what's the difference between indigenous and aboriginal? Are they the same thing?
Okay.
That is one question. And then another question is, okay, the other question I will save for later. But yeah, can you clear the indigenous versus aboriginal doubt?
The indigenous and the aboriginal, the meaning is same, but every country, in Australia, the word for the aboriginal is the another word for Adivasi, and indigenous is also the another word for Adivasi in America. And in Canada, the indigenous people are called First Nations. तो जैसे कि अमेरिका में indigenous है, इंडिया में आदिवासी है, तो meaning same है, अलग नहीं है. The meaning is same, but in different countries, they are called in different names. Like in Japan, there are also some आदिवासी communities. They call themselves as Ainu. So they have all different names. The main thing is indigenous means native. The first settlers of that country are the indigenous, the aboriginal. And in India, the indigenous people, the native of this land, are called Adivasi. Is it, am I clear?
Can I just add to that? This is Ankush.
Yeah, Ankush.
Very, very rightly pointed out, Ashish. Indigenous is the larger umbrella term which is used for indigenous communities globally. And it is an accepted term by the United Nations. So there is a convention of the indigenous people, which a lot of countries ratify. First Nations, Aboriginals, Scheduled Tribes, these are the different terminologies that respective governments and respective communities of different countries have chosen to refer themselves as. And that is what is the most important thing. United Nations recognizes that indigenous communities have the sole right to decide how they shall be referenced by communities themselves and by the non-indigenous communities. Like in India, they call themselves Adivasis. In Australia, they call themselves Aboriginals. In Canada, it's First Nations. In the US, it's Indigenous or Natives. It's all the same thing. It all comes under the larger umbrella of Indigenous communities. Thank you.
Thank you, Ankush. And what was the another question?
The other question was, should Adivasis be allowed to stay near forest covers under government? And then how can reservation for Adivasis help the generals? So you can answer that question now or in the end. It's from Brahma Puspita.
Can anyone help me answering this? Ankush?
Yes. The first question was, should Adivasis be allowed to live near the forest? Is that
the under the government? That's the question. If you want to clarify and be more specific about your question, Brahma Puspita.
Yes. But I would just like to add here, and I'm sorry, I'm not taking away from Ashish. He obviously will share his own opinions. But having worked with Adivasi Lives Matter and working with Adivasis for the last 4-5 years now, there have been certain realizations that I have gathered, and I'll just share those. Point number one is, across different civilizations, indigenous communities have been pushed to the forests. Like Mughal invasion, like British invasion, the Maratha invasion, whatever invasions took place. And because the indigenous people were always living close to nature, and they lived a nature-dependent life, forest-dependent life, they have lived in proximity of forests, but they have been pushed farther into the forest by successive different invasions. And in a way, the invasion continues today in the name of mining, in the name of Naxalism, which pushes them further towards the forests. Having said that, there is a general conception among the masses that the indigenous communities are harming the forests. That if they live in the forest, they're going to deplete the forest cover. They're going to kill the wildlife. Now, we understand where this comes from, because non-indigenous communities have always looked at the world as a resource which is up for using and abusing. But that's a very interesting point. Indigenous communities are some of the most, quote unquote, sustainable communities in the world, because they understand that this river is mine, this tree is mine, this forest is mine. So I shall not use more than what is required. So there have been enough researches across the world which demonstrate that indigenous communities have actually conserved forests, they have conserved the biodiversity. And here's a very interesting fact. Indigenous people are less than 5% of the world's population, but they govern 80% of the world's forest biodiversity. This is a known scientific fact. This is not just a feel-good kind of statistic, you know? So these are the realities of indigenous people living in the forest. And something which is very interesting, which people don't understand, the term forest or the forest department was constituted by the British in the 1900s. The Indian government inherited the forest policy constituted by the British. Do people ever realize that even before the Forest Department was constituted, the indigenous communities have been living and guarding these forests for millenniums, not just centuries? So clearly they predate the government departments, the formation of India, the formation of states, and all of the above. So the relationship between indigenous communities and forests is extremely, extremely integral to their identity. Having said that, not all indigenous communities live in forests. People like Ashish and a lot of other people that we work with live in cities. Some of them have settled abroad. Some of them have settled in different cities of India. So it's a heterogeneous mix. When Ashish asked earlier, what do we think of as Adivasis? The first thing we think of when we say the word Adivasi is someone who lives in the forest. That is not true. 60% may be living in forest, 70% may be living in forest. But 30, 40 have now migrated and moved to cities and are doing jobs and are doing everything else. Sorry if that was a really long response.
Yeah. I would like to add one thing. The the very first when बोलते हैं ना कि सबसे पहले तो पूरा पूरा जो धरती है ये जंगल से ही भरा हुआ था. तो जब लोग आते हैं तो वो खेत बनाते हैं और पूरा जंगल को काटते हैं, खेत बनाते हैं. तो रहने के लिए आप सही करते हैं, मतलब कि थोड़ा सा पेड़ काटते हैं जो जितना आपका जरूरत है खेती करने के लिए. तो ये एक चीज होता है. तो लेकिन जब बाहर से लोग आते हैं, जब आक्रमण होता है आदिवासियों के ऊपर, तो लोग वहां से हट करके फिर जंगल की तरफ और चले जाते हैं. फिर जब वहां पर जाते हैं तो फिर वहां पर भी वैसा ही उनका जीविका चलता है. वहां पर भी लोग फिर से खेत बनाते हैं अपना खेती करने के लिए. फिर से जब वहां पर फिर से आक्रमण होता है तो फिर वो फिर से और जंगल की तरफ चले जाते हैं. तो ये जो आदिवासी कम्युनिटी है, स्पेशली दी हो पीपल, दे ट्रूली लाइक टू लिव इन द फॉरेस्ट एंड आई हैव एक्सपीरियंस्ड दिस. बट दिस इज नॉट ट्रू इन एवरी प्लेस. इन इफ यू गो टू वेस्ट सिंहभूम देर इज नो फॉरेस्ट, यू वोंट सी एनी फॉरेस्ट लाइक इन इन ईस्ट सिंहभूम. जैसे कि वेस्ट सिंहभूम जो चाईबासा एरिया है वहां पर उतने जंगल नहीं है. वहां आपको बोलते हैं कि हमारा हमारा एक वर्ड है, हमारा होप है टांडी दिसुम. तो ये टांडी दिसुम बोलते हैं जो टांडी है जहां पर पेड़ नहीं मिलेंगे आपको, जंगल नहीं मिलेंगे. तो वहां वो टांडी दिसुम में लोग रहते हैं. तो उनके पास ऑप्शन रहता है कि आप टांडी दिसुम में रहेंगे या फिर आप जंगल पे रहेंगे. बट द मेन थिंग इज इसमें और भी हिस्ट्री पे ये भी लिखा जाता है, जब अकाल पड़ता है तो लोग जंगल तरफ जाते हैं क्योंकि जंगल पे ही आपका जीने का जो फ्रूट्स है, जो खाने के लिए जो भी उपलब्धियां मिलती है आपको, वो जंगल से ही मिलती है. तो वो एक फैक्ट है कि लोग जंगल के तरफ जाते हैं. और दूसरा ये होता है कि पहले के टाइम पे आदिवासी लोग जो है वो हंट करते थे, दे यूज टू हंट. एंड जब हंट करते हैं दे आर अफ्रेड ऑफ वाइल्ड एनिमल्स एंड दे गो डीप इन टू द फॉरेस्ट एंड दे हाइड देमसेल्व्स. तो जो जहां छुप जाते हैं फिर वहां पर उनका फिर जनरेशन बढ़ता है, वहीं पर फिर लोग बसना शुरू कर देते हैं. तो हमारा इतिहास इस तरह से है और इस तरह से लोग हैं. तो पीपल हैव चॉइस कि वो जंगल पे रहना चाहते हैं या फिर वो टांडी दिसुम में रहना चाहते हैं, प्लेन एरिया पे है. लेकिन ऐसे भी है कि लोग भगा दिया गया है वो, और वो मजबूरी में रह रहे हैं, वैसे भी है. तो बहुत सारा ये कहानियां है ये सब.
Two more questions. So this is from Ruhi Kumar. The recent forest policy and dilution of environmental norms, how do we go forward in the way the government is going ahead with plundering resources? Basically, with all the environmental degradation that's happening due to government approval, how do we move forward in the future? That's the question.
Okay. Can I speak and then Ashish could add?
For sure.
Right. So this is Ankush again. Shiranjini, I think there are two things from what you are saying. One is environmental degradation, which is interlinked to indigenous communities, but the forest policy is a dedicated thing which directly affects the indigenous communities. So I would like to address both. The National Forest Policy, which is now being revised, and in 2019, there were the new amendments that came out, is that that policy gives an almost army-like authority to the forest guards, to the forest police, so much so that they can fire at will and kill people who are suspected as being part of poaching or taking undue advantage of the forest. Now, that is really interesting because the government has always looked at the forest as a resource which is productive. Productive meaning for economic reasons. It could be for timber, it could be for forest produce, it could be for anything. Whereas the Adivasis have looked at the forest as a home, And that is where inherent differences lie. Nobody is going to sell out their home just for economic benefits, but the government will, because the government has never owned and lived in the forest. They look at it as a productive resource. So which is the big difference? The National Forest Policy only speaks of productivity. They speak of monoculture plantations, which they think is a forest. So they will talk of increasing tree cover or green cover without actually giving due consideration to native species or biodiversity or anything else.
Ruhi here. I asked the question. Actually, I'm only interested in the forest draft policy, which is a complete sham from what you say. And the specifically on the Forest Rights Act, the FRA, the Adivasis in India. Those two parts. So your first part is absolutely to the point, but if you could just throw some more light on the FRA and the impact on Adivasis in India.
Right. So the Forest Rights Act, as some of you may know, for the others who do not know, was an absolutely legendary piece of policy, which was passed in 2006, December, which for the first time in the statement of the law itself says that we recognize the historical injustice done to the indigenous communities of this country, how they have always had to sacrifice their home, their forest for developmental projects. The law stated that. It was a very progressive law, still is. Unfortunately, the cadre of ministers who made this law changed over time. And now with the current government, obviously, there is immense exploitation of forest resources and forest lands for mining, for XYZ, different reasons. And then they are at absolute loggerheads with the indigenous people who live in these forests. So there is constant amendment to dilute the Forest Rights Act. Be it the Land Acquisition LARR amendment, which came across in 2013, or the subsequent, you know, like Ashish said, we are supposed to prove our identity and that we live in these forests. So that is what has been happening for the last couple of years, which obviously reached its peak. The court cases have been going on since 2006. What's interesting is that the law was passed in 2006.
Hello, Ankush.
Evidence that there has been depletion in forest cover. So the forest, Hanji, Ashish?
I think we missed something. Aapka awaaz nahi aa raha tha.
Oh, I'm sorry. But to cut the long point short.
We can't hear you again.
Ganesh Maji, aap kuch bolna chahenge?
In the colonial way. Hello?
Ganesh Maji would like to say something.
Yes, please.
You're muted.
Ganesh ji? Aap.
Yeah. So I don't have the separate answer for the question that has been asked. So Ankush has rightly answered the question, I feel. So there is no response for the question from my side.
Mahendra? So Ganesh Maji is, he's an indigenous friend. And Mahendra also. Lots of my indigenous friends have joined, and if they want to answer, they can also answer. आप लोगों को अगर कुछ बोलना है सपोर्ट पे, क्योंकि मैं एक्सपर्ट नहीं हूँ, आप लोगों को ही मदद करना है मुझे. तो यहाँ पर हम लोग सबको ही मिल करके सवालों के जवाब देंगे. महेंद्र भाई, आप भी अगर कुछ बोलना चाह रहे हैं तो आप जरूर बताइए. महेंद्र भाई, आपका, हाँ
हेलो,
हाँ हाँ अभी सुनाई दे रहा है आप.
गुड इवनिंग.
हाँ गुड इवनिंग.
वेरी वेल डिस्कशन इज गोइंग ऑन एंड अ नॉलेज शेयरिंग एंड अच्छा लग रहा है, बहुत ही अच्छा लग रहा है. और आपने भी अब तक जितना भी जानकारी दिया उपलब्ध कराया अच्छा था, और अभी जी हमारे साथ जुड़े थे काफी अच्छा लग रहा था उनका भी। अगर मुझे कुछ एक्स्ट्रा लगता है इसमें तो मैं कुछ बोलूंगा बीच में, लेकिन अभी फिलहाल मैं सुनना ही पसंद कर रहा
हूँ। बिल्कुल कोई बात नहीं है।
Okay. So if you want to wrap up and add some points, and then we can just make it open to questions.
So I want to make this point that there's a lot of benefit in living in middle of the forest. The first thing is during this quarantine time, during this time when people cannot go outside and buy vegetables and the resources are very limited now, the people in the people, the Adivasi people are actually enjoying. It's not bothering them. The threat is if the corona gets spread in the village, then there will be a huge tragedy. तो अभी 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 हो क्या रहा है कि गांव पे लोग जो जंगलों पे रहते हैं वो क्या कर रहे हैं, जो भी है यहाँ पर मोरिंगा साग बहुत फेमस है, द मोरिंगा साग हर घर पे आपको 70-80% मोरिंगा साग आपको मिलेंगे। तो क्या कर रहे हैं लोग अभी के टाइम में, मोरिंगा साग खा रहे पूरा, दे आर ईटिंग ड्रम स्टिक and they are bringing lots of vegetables from forest, so they are able to survive somehow and they have this survival skill. Hame man versus wild nahi dekhna hai, hame ye survival skill seekhne ke liye ye hame malum hai. And if government aise logo ko jo wo dependent nahi hai bazaar se, aise logo ko aap jangalon se bahar khaded bhagoge to wo kya karenge fir? तो फिर ये तो दिक्कत है। तो ये अभी के टाइम में भी हम लोग एनी हाउ वी आर मैनेजिंग टू सर्वाइव। सो ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है। और सबसे मैं एक्सपीरियंस अपना शेयर करना चाह रहा हूँ। हम लोग बहुत सारा सवाल आया है लेकिन नोबडी इज आस्किंग द क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू आइडेंटिटी। या सो आई वॉज एक्सपेक्टिंग मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम आइडेंटिटी, what identity and Adivasis, because we are making a series and I will try to touch everything in this series. This is the first part, and three more parts are in the list, and in every week we will have this webinar if Sri Ranjani agrees.
For sure.
And I would like to continue my experience. A recent friend of mine told me that Ashish, let's make a textile company. He will become a multimillionaire, and he is staying in Gujarat. And I told that yeah, it's a very good idea. But he told me initially you have to go to a factory and you have to take an experience. You have to work with them, but there's a condition. You don't have to reveal your identity, he told me. And in Gujarat, he thinks it's a Modi pro zone, so it's not a good idea to reveal your identity there. So I told I think you can guess what it might have happened. What was my response? So everywhere we have to face this truth that somehow we are forced to hide our identity. If you have questions, anything related to identity, please ask me. You can ask me.
I wanted to add to what Ashish said about identity, if I may. This is Ankush.
Yes.
Right. So, see, we over the last few years or decades, I should say, we have seen identity assertion come in different movements, be it the gender rights movement, be it the disability rights movement, be it the LGBTQ rights movement. Different marginalized sections of the society have the issue always begins with asserting identity. And this has somehow escaped in the discourse with Adivasis or indigenous communities of India, because every time there has been a battle for land, for survival, for life, for livelihood. And you know, this has not been a battle now, this has been a battle for a very, very long time. And so which is a reason I feel that the battle for asserting identities has not really come to the forefront. I really laud the Dalit movement, the Ambedkarite movement for this, because they really took this head on. And in the last 10 years, 15 years, they have really addressed Dalit identity very, very strongly. And we continue to learn from their movements, be it artists, be it singers, be it dancers, be it performers, hip-hop artists like Sumit Samos, who is an international Dalit hip-hop performer. So identity assertion has been an integral part of the struggle in Dalits and other marginalized communities. We have not seen that in Adivasis, which is why it was so important when Ashish decided to speak about Adivasi identity. Because typically when we speak of Adivasis, it's always these things. It's the Forest Rights Act, it's the forest policy, it's the mining, it's Naxalism, it's malnutrition, it's lack of literacy, it's all of these things. But everything at the root of this is the question of identity. Are you going to recognize Adivasi communities as Adivasis? The RSS calls them as Vanvasis. Modiji calls it as Girijan. Gandhiji called it something else. Ambedkarji called it something else. The first step in acceptance of anyone is to call them by the names that they want to call themselves. You know, like the disability rights movement is not so happy where the Modi government is calling them Divyang. They're like, there is nothing Divya about us. There is nothing divine about us. We are not ashamed of saying that we are people with disabilities. Why are you calling us by a different name? So this is a concerted effort, and I think we should recognize that. To wipe out identity slowly. How this gets wiped out, and I'll just take another minute, is also through our entire education system. So in my travels across Adivasi regions in the world, I have been to a lot of states, and when I went to the Niyamgiri mountains in Odisha, the famous Niyamgiri mountains, and where the Dongriyakond Adivasis fought against Vedanta, they won the court case. So I was speaking to some young people in Niyamgiri mountains, and see, you'll see very stark contrast. The older people, the men in Niyamgiri, have really long hair. So if you see them from the back, you won't be able to really recognize if it's a man or a woman. And you see that among indigenous communities in US, men have really long hair, they will tie plaids and all. Same in Niyamgiri mountains, Odisha. But the younger people have short hair, very short hair. So I asked him, why the difference? I was talking to a few school-going, college-going youth. And they said, there is a Ramakrishna Mission school in which all of them go to, because there is no village school. The government infrastructure is crumbling. And they said, the first thing we have to do when we go to the school is to chop off our hair. We are not allowed to grow hair, long hair. Men are not allowed to grow long hair. They said, we are not allowed to speak in our language. We are not allowed to follow any of our rituals or customs. So this, mind you, begins from an extremely early age, the wiping out of one's identity. And this is called as cultural genocide in countries like India, in countries like Canada, Australia, US. But in India, there is no conversation about these things. So it's an extremely, extremely pertinent point what Ashish is discussing today. Adivasi identity is at the root of treating Adivasis respectfully, of respecting their rights, of respecting their agency. And it all begins with something as simple as accepting the identity of Adivasis as they want it. And Adivasi may say, call me tribal. We should respect that and call them what they want. The problem is where non-indigenous people decide what should be called to Adivasi people or indigenous people. Who are we to decide, right? And we've learned that through the gender movement. We've learned that through the disability movement, through the LGBTQ movement. We should accord the agency of calling what they want to be called to them, not to us. It's not upon us to decide that. Sorry, that's all that I wanted to say. Sorry if I prolonged it.
Thank you.
And in this discussion, Angush Bhai and Sri Ranjani and Disha, I'm not trying to convey that non-tribals are the villain. Yeah, you have to understand that. I'm not creating a difference, but accepting what is truth.
Okay, now shall we open the floor to questions? That was really insightful. Thank you for that. Now, whoever wants to ask questions or just say how they felt about what they learned so far, the floor is open. First, we have Gangotri who wants to speak, and then we have Disha. Gangotri, you may speak now.
Yeah, I have a question related to conservation and preservation of nature. And whatever do we put a text in the chat box that the Adivasis probably have the most symbolic relationship with the earth and elements around them. I also feel that, and the term worshipping, I feel that worshipping is not something that generally considered as a superstition. Worshipping is meaning that appreciation and loving towards something, to worship that. So Adivasi people worships every element of nature, being it a tree, be it a rock, be it some animal, everything. But the so-called civilized people considers this as a superstition rather to observe the maintenance of nature. So how can we break the misconception of that so-called civilized people about the worshipness and maintenance of nature?
So this question is for me.
We represent the Adivasi culture as a we should also do this appreciation and maintenance, like worshipping towards nature.
So
we can adopt the culture. We should adopt this culture from them.
Yeah. So
Can I respond to this question, Ashish, if you allow?
Yes.
Yeah, so responding to the question raised, I mean, I can give an example of the Karam festival. So like when we cut the part of the branch of the tree of the Karam, we don't chop up the whole tree. So we just take the branch of the tree, bring it to the village. That is what we call Akhra. We put it there, we worship there, we dance there, and then kind of celebration goes whole night. And then in the entire day, before the night, for the whole day, there is fasting that's normally being done by the unmarried boys and girls. And so worshipping the nature in one way, which is kind of saving the nature in terms of tree here, and at the same time, you're worshipping as well and not chopping the whole entire tree. I'm just giving an example, you know, like there can be many examples.
Yeah, I'm going to give an example. Like in Jadugoda, we cook food with firewood, and we are staying here like since 100 years. We have migrated to this place like in 1900 or something. So since that time, we have been using firewood, and the Adivasis, the majority, the population has increased here, and the people have been bringing firewoods from the tree. So when they bring firewood from the forest, they don't cut the whole tree. They bring the wood which is raw, or they will cut at a certain part where the tree will not die, and from that place the another branch will grow. So since 100 years we have been cutting the trees which we need for firewood, but the forest is not destroyed. You can still see lots of trees here. But imagine if any business person comes here and he cut trees for making furniture. So he will destroy the whole forest in just 1 year. So that's a difference. We will consume only that much, how much we need, not more than that.
speak first. I'll speak after.
Yeah, okay. So another two examples that I want to give. So like I haven't been into Buster, but then I was reading the book called Ecology Economics, and one of the chapter written by Felix Pedel. So he was explaining about the forest product, which is fruit that he was explaining. So the first season when the fruit falls on the land, those people, the tribal people of the Buster, they don't consume that. And they leave for the regeneration purposes. Only in the second season, when the fruit start falling, they kind of start consuming. That's one way of, you know, the nature tribe relationship in terms of consuming that much so that nature can sustain itself. Another example, once I was talking to one of my friends from Uttarakhand, and he was telling this story there that ek bar aisa hua ki wahan pe jalavan ke liye lakdi nahi mil rahi thi. So you know, those people who are from the city asked ki aisa kya problem hai ki jalavan ke liye lakdi nahi mil rahi hai. To unhone kaha ki is bar aandhi nahi aayi. What's the point? Point is, aandhi nahi aayi, ped nahi gira, sukha nahi, isliye jalavan ke liye unko dikkat ho rahi hai. So these are some of other examples from other areas.
Actually, my concern is bit different. I am trying to explain with an example. अभी अगर हमारे आजू बाजू में देखा जाए तो कहीं पे कोई पेड़ कोई कट रहा है तो कॉमन पीपल जाके रोकते नहीं है क्योंकि मैक्सिमम पीपल को लगता नहीं है कि हाँ पेड़ कट रहा है तो हमारा क्या जा रहा है ऐसा. तो अगर ये वर्शिपिंग कल्चर हमारे में भी स्टार्ट होंगे तो हम किसी को वर्शिप करते हैं उसको अगर काटा जा रहा है तो सब जाके रोक लेंगे. तो मेरा कंसर्न यही है कि ये नेचर के एलिमेंट को वर्शिप करना, ये कल्चर हम कॉमन पीपल या हम में कैसे ग्रो कर सकते हैं.
दैट्स वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट राधा. आई ट्राइड प्लांटिंग वन करम ट्री इन JNU सो दैट यू नो आई कैन टेल माय फ्रेंड्स दैट आई हैव ग्रोन हियर एंड दे विल स्टार्ट वर्शिपिंग इन JNU कैंपस बट राइट ग्रोन वेल एनफ देन अनफॉर्चूनेटली इट कुड डाई. I have planted another tree, which is the sal tree. It's growing well so far. But anyway, so the point that I was trying to convey here is that in, for example, in my area, my hometown is in the border of Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, and Odisha. And the non-tribal people living there, they have also started worshipping or celebrating Karam festival for that matter. So, you know, you can understand they are in a way like, it's not really, they might be thinking ki like nature ko bachana hai, but then the philosophy if you try to bring out of there, you know, theek hai, worship kar rahe hai, at the same time we need to respect that worship of the nature. At the same time you're celebrating in terms of festival as well. So yeah, I think it can well be taken from the tribal philosophy and then the life, the way they are living.
If I can just add to what Ganesh said.
Yes.
I slightly disagree with, sorry, I forgot the name of the person who was asking the question.
Gangotri.
Yeah. But Gangotri, I don't completely agree with the fact that if we worship, we save. We worship women in the form of different goddesses. We treat them absolutely inhumanly. So I do not think that worshiping is equal to saving something. Indigenous communities, Adivasis, world over, worshipping is an expression of the inherent value system of these communities. Unfortunately, worshipping is also a subset of the bhakti movement which India went through and what the world went through. The worshipping was a movement that went through. And that is a movement jiske after effects mein hum log abhi jee rahe hai. Worshipping does not unfortunately is equivalent to saving something. What, if I hear you correctly, is what you're talking of is how can the non-indigenous communities imbibe the values of saving? And worshipping is a form of showing that respect. So I fully agree with what Ganesh said, that respecting something is essential. I mean, we may be worshipping cows, but India is the biggest beef exporter in the world. So worship is not equal to saving. We may worship Datta Bhagwan ka vahan hota hai, a dog, but we cut dogs, we kill dogs, like, you know, worshipping is not equal to saving in my opinion, and I may be wrong, but what needs to be inculcated is a sense of value of respect, is a sense and value that there is a finite resource and all of us need to do this. And I think नेचर वर्शिपिंग के एक स्टेप पहले आएगा रिस्पेक्टिंग द ह्यूमंस हु हैव बीन लॉन्गेस्ट ऑन द प्लैनेट एंड विच आर द इंडिजिनियस कम्युनिटीज बिकॉज सो आई वुड से कि लेट अस ऑफकोर्स वर्शिप एंड रिस्पेक्ट ट्रीज एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ एंड एवरीथिंग बट ये सवाल कोई कभी भी नहीं पूछता है कि इन पेड़ों को और इन जानवरों को आज तक किसने बचा के रखा इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन वेरी वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन एंड लाइक आशीष एंड गणेश वर गिविंग एग्जांपल्स आई हैव दिस पर्सनल एग्जांपल वेयर आई वाज इन स्पिति एंड हैड द रेयर अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ सीइंग अ स्नो लेपर्ड फीस्ट ऑन अ डोंकी एंड आई मीन जर्नलिस्ट हैड कम फ्रॉम अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड एंड दे वर वेटिंग फॉर मंथ्स एंड वी वेंट एंड वी सॉ दैट इन लाइक लिटरली द फर्स्ट आवर ऑफ अस रीचिंग किबर विलेज इन स्पिति And so I was talking to the villagers who were showing us that. And I said, aren't you a little pissed that, because they use mules for taking their saman upar niche on the mountains. And I said, aren't you pissed that the leopard is eating your mule? They're like, oh no. So there was an interesting story. This leopard was injured in a fight with another leopard. And this was a donkey which was slightly weaker. They in fact offered the donkey to the leopard because they knew the leopard could not hunt so well. They said, everything that we have is for everybody else. We may be using these mules for our benefit. That does not give us dominion on those mules. We have to share it with everyone else. So, worship karenge to sharing tendency nahi aayegi. Phir bolenge, ye to hamara hi hai, ye to hamara hi hai. But the Adivasi ideology is that ki we are a part of nature and we are nature and nature is a part of us. So everything is for everyone. ये सिर्फ मेरा नहीं है. I can't use it just for personal gain. Same case with the Aare Colony Adivasis, the Varli Adivasis in Aare, Mumbai, which is possibly the only place in the world where humans and leopards coexist. I have been going to Aare Colony since childhood. My grandfather was the chief executive officer of the Aare Milk Colony. So we know the ideology of the indigenous people there. They're like, if the leopards don't kill our cattle, what are they going to eat? We have made a city in their home. Who's at fault? The leopard is not at fault. We are infringing on the leopard's space. The leopard is just coming and eating like he or she was for the last few thousands of years. So this is a known fact among indigenous communities. Worship karenge to kya hoga kal ko? Fir banduk se hum log us janwar ko maar denge agar wo aake hamare ped khayega ya hamare janwar khayega. Kyunki worshipping ki ye dusri side hum log aaj India mein dekhte bhi hai. Hai na? We get very possessive when we start worshipping something. So I would say a mutual sense of respect, a mutual sense of empathy, and I would say a mutual sense of appreciation, what you rightly said, towards the indigenous communities. And just lastly, I wanted to say that indigenous communities ke saath, the basic policy that I think all of us non-indigenous people should have is ask. Don't tell. We do the exact opposite. We tell and we don't ask. So we should just ask first and then we will be enriched with so many more point of views. Sorry, that's all I had to say.
So isme main add karna chahunga ye khaskar non indigenous groups ke liye aap log contribute kar sakte hain bahut sara cheez jaise hamara ek belief hai hamara adivasi community pe ki आप लाइफ में जितना भी सक्सेसफुल बन जाओ लेकिन आप अगर लाइफ में एक भी पेड़ नहीं लगाए तो आप कुछ नहीं किए हो लाइफ में. तो ये आपको आप अपना करियर बाद में लेकिन आप लाइफ में जितना पेड़ लगा सकते हैं वो लगाइए. क्योंकि हमारा एक बिलीव है कि जितने हमारे पेड़ रहेंगे हमारे कम्युनिटी पे उतने हमारे जो भगवान हम जिसमें बिलीव करते हैं वो उतने पावरफुल होते हैं. द नेचर विल बी कम मोर स्ट्रॉन्गर. तो ये एक हमारा एक थिंकिंग है. और जहाँ ये जो हम लोग जैसे हमारा गांव पे हम लोग गांव पे मुर्गियां पाल करके रखते हैं जो चिकन है तो हमारा जंगल के सामने है घर. तो जंगल से एक वाइल्ड बिल्ली आती है जिसे हम लोग बाउ बोलते हैं हमारा लैंग्वेज पे. वो चिकन को लेकर के वो खाती है. तो कभी कभी क्या होता है कि हम लोग कभी कभी हम लोग लगता है कि अरे चिकन खा गया वो तो हमारे लिए था वो तो हमारा भोजन था. लेकिन एक्चुअल पे क्या है कि वो भोजन हमारा नहीं है उनका भोजन है. पहले चिकन हम लोग आजकल जंगल पे चिकन जंगली चिकन भी मिलते हैं जो जंगल पे पाए जाते हैं. आज के टाइम पे वो जो जंगली चिकन है वो जंगल पे नहीं मिलते हैं तो उनके लिए जो है वो अभी खत्म हो गया है. तो वो क्या करते हैं जो जंगली बिल्ली है जो बाऊ है वो घर घर जा करके जो घर का जो पाल के रखे वो चिकन को खाता है, तो आप वो बिल्ली को आप नहीं मार सकते हो, उनको खाने दो। वो एक है कि लोग नहीं मारते हैं और कोई कुछ लोग जो है वो मारते भी हैं, लेकिन मेरे घर में हम लोग ये फॉलो करते हैं कि ये उनका भोजन है, वो रोज नहीं खाता है, वीकली एक उठा के ले जाएगा या मंथली एक उठा के ले जाएगा, वो एक घर से आज उठाएगा कल दूसरे घर से उठाएगा, वो एक चीज है। तो वही है, ये अंडरस्टैंडिंग होना चाहिए। और दूसरा जो मैंने पेड़ लगाने का जो बात किया है वो आप लोग सीरियसली जरूर फॉलो कीजिए। और कोई सवाल है?
I just have a question with respect to the language of identity. Like, even in the questions as we were asking, I noticed a lot of us, we say like Adivasi people, civilized people, indigenous people, common people. So what would the right terminology be while referencing to Adivasi and indigenous people and then comparing them to like the rest?
Ankush
has to leave.
Yes, I'll just answer this and then maybe I will leave. I have another call. But I think that has been established, Sri Ranjani, and it's a learning process. Very small trivia that when we started Adivasi Lives Matter, we started it as Tribal Lives Matter, because the government of India calls them scheduled tribes, and the entire government documentation refers to indigenous communities as tribal. All media organizations, all journalists, all news, everybody calls it tribal. Internationally also tribal is used, not used. But then I read this book by Nandini Sundar, which is an Oxford Press publication, The Scheduled Tribes and Their India. And everyone should read that book if they want to. Extremely wonderful resource. It's almost like a textbook. Oxford Printing Press has done that. And over there, she very rightly mentions that the government has always denied the Adivasis from the right to call themselves what they want. Now, let's understand. Adivasi is a Hindi word. This is not again necessarily something that may have come from one Adivasi community. It may again have been an imposition of the Hindi speaking North Indian people on the indigenous communities, which is fair enough. But if this is what the Adivasi communities want to call themselves, then this is what we stick to. A certain deflection over here takes place in the Northeast, because people in the Northeast do not prefer calling themselves Adivasi. People in the Northeast of India call themselves tribal, because they want to call themselves tribal. So, which is why, even in our wordage, even in our, whenever we are writing, we say Adivasi and tribal. So we are being cognizant of the people of what they want to call themselves as. See, there are about 1,000 indigenous communities in India. There are going to be immense differences of opinions. There's going to be a lot of different ideologies. So we cannot obviously go into all of them, but we obviously respect the major ideologies and thought processes that are there. So Adivasi is East India, Central India, South India. The communities, activists, organizations prefer to call themselves as Adivasis. Northeast India, they prefer to call themselves as tribals or scheduled tribes. And And overall term, unfortunately in India, people also are a little, I would say, ignorant, even among the activist circles and also. Someone may loosely call the indigenous people of India as aboriginals, or someone may call as First Nations. On Twitter, we see this a lot, which is great. It all really means the same thing. And if they want to call themselves aboriginals, then they call themselves aboriginals. It's as simple as that. Who are he or she or whoever else to say that they cannot? But for regular parlance, for regular conversations, we say Adivasis and tribals under the larger umbrella of indigenous communities.
Okay. My question was more like, if we're comparing indigenous people and non-indigenous people in the same sentence, what do we call non-indigenous people in India? Because like a lot of people say, oh, Adivasi people and civilized people, or Adivasi people and common people, and that it's often not the same. That was my question.
That is very incorrect. You can't say Adivasis and civilized.
Exactly. Adivasis and non-Adivasis is what we say.
We say Adivasis and non-Adivasis.
Okay. Yes, that was my question. Thank you.
That's basically how we refer.
Yeah.
Yes. I'm really sorry, but I'm going to have to take your leave, and I'm sure Ashish, Ganesh, and all of you will continue the conversation. Thank you so much for arranging this, Sriranjani. Clearly, this was much needed and a big hit, and looking forward to the next one.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you, Ashish, and everyone for joining. Thank you. Thank you.
Any final thoughts, questions before we wrap up?
Hi, question. I'd asked if you have any recommendation for like a book or a historical event or something that you think is sort of essential reading, or is it something essential that every Indian should be aware of, is something that I was considering to understand Adivasi identity or something of that sort. Do you think there's something essential that we should know? Yeah.
There's a book by Gladson Dung Dung. The author name is Gladson Dung Dung. He mostly write books on Adivasis. So try to read all the books. I don't have his books, but the author name is very important. Please note down the author name. Gladson Dung Dung from Jharkhand.
Okay. Yeah.
And there's another important book. I have not read that book, but I was recommended by one of my friend. And there are lots of books in Adivasi language also. So I cannot, because we now the people from my community also have started writing books in our own script. Okay, let me. There's a book and whatever points I had made today, there's a particular book for that. In the year 2011 on 5th January, Supreme Court gave a judgment that Adivasis are the Aboriginal of India. So that book name is the Judgment of Supreme Court and the Rights of Adivasis. Hello?
Hello. Your screen is frozen.
Okay. Actually, I am looking the name of the book. Wait.
Okay. Yeah. We need. We are going to wrap up now. It's 1.5 hours, which is amazing.
There's a book, Tribal Education in India by Bijay Kamath. That's a very good book. Tribal Education in India by Bijay Kamath.
Okay, thank you.
Which was the book Angus was talking about?
It's Scheduled Tribes of India by Nandini Sundar.
Nandini Sundar.
Thank you so much, Ashish. This was amazing. We learned a lot. We're looking forward to the next session. If you want to give us like a hint of what the next session is going to be about, what topic?
The next topic will be on Adivasi religion beliefs. Yeah. So lots of questions have arrived today, but we'll touch everything on that. So yes, I'm going to touch everything. No worry.
Yeah.
But my focus was on Adivasi identity today.
Yeah.
And next will be Adivasi. What is the relation of Adivasis with Mother Nature? And what are their beliefs? And what religion do we follow? And there's more coming that in tribal culture, we don't believe in heaven or earth. We have on our own sets of beliefs. So I'll touch everything.
For those who don't know, please check out Adivasi Lives Matter on the internet. that's how I got connected to Ashish and Ankush, and I'm so grateful. And they do great work through Youth Ki Awaaz. Ashish is also a photojournalist, and I hope we get to see some of your pictures and your work too. Looking forward to the next session. Thank you so much, everybody. I'm going to end the meeting now.
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.
This was a great session.
Johar.
Johar.
Ganesh bhai, Johar.
Johar.